Hello, everybody, and welcome to Pronunciation Live from BBC Learning English. This is the show where you send in the words that you have difficulty pronouncing and we help you to pronounce them. My name is Nina, and please do get in the comments box and let me know who you are and where in the world you are joining us from today. Before we begin, I will just remind you that if you do have a pair of headphones, it's a great idea to put those in now, turn the volume up nice and loud so you can hear the words that are being pronounced nice and clearly. Do remember that this is a pronunciation show, not a vocabulary show, so I will cover word meaning a little where I can, but we won't focus too heavily on that. And I am a native speaker, but all native speakers speak English with their accent. And you might hear slight differences in the way that I pronounce things than other native speakers might pronounce them. But there are more similarities than there are differences. Okay, let's take a look. So Ilyas Khan from Pakistan. I didn't say your name the other day. I'm very sorry. I've said it today. A very big hello to you and everybody else who is joining us from Pakistan. We've got Yasushi from Japan. Hello and welcome to the show. Rolando in Colombia. Hello and welcome to you. We've got Shada joining from Libya. Welcome. Claudia is back and sending good vibes to everybody from sunny Italy. It's sunny with me as well today, Claudia. So I'm glad you are also enjoying good weather. Vera joining us from Brazil, a very big hello to you. And Pradeep in Australia, hello and welcome to the show. Let's have a look here. We've got Thomas is a BBC Learning English fan member, and it's been a long time, so welcome back to you, Thomas, joining us from Melbourne in Australia. We've got Akram from Oman. Hello and welcome to the show. We've got Fakiri somewhere in the world. Hello to you. We have got Madhu joining us from India. And we've got Amalia from Nicaragua. Hello and welcome. Oops, let's take a look here. We have got Fizan joining us from Afghanistan, and Christiane says good morning from Brazil. A very good morning to you over there. Okay, well, it is Thursday. It's just gone 1:30, and therefore it is time for Pronunciation Live, the show where you send in the words that you have difficulty pronouncing and we help you to pronounce them. So please do get in the comments box and add in any words that you would like help with, and I will get through as many as I can. Now, before we get to those words, let's take a look at today's challenge. And the question today is, which of these words have three syllables? By syllables, I mean the number of separate or the number of sounds in the word. So syllable has three syllables. Which other words have three syllables that you can see? So please get in the comments box and let me know what you think. Okay, how many of these words have three syllables? We have got Jessica, who says the answer is B. Xian thinks the answer is A, B, and C. We have got, who else? I can't read your name, but A and C is your guess. Adams thinks the answer is C. Rita thinks that B has three syllables. Mary thinks the answer is C. Jew thinks the answer is B. Yasushi says B and C question mark. Is it B and C? We will come back at the end of the show. We will practice the pronunciation of these words and we will see which ones have just three syllables. All right, let's take a look at some of the words that were sent in. So Yevgeny would like to practice this sentence or this phrase, the three children, the three. Now the TH at the beginning of the is a different sound than the TH at the beginning of three, because the We use our voice to make the sound the, and three, we don't use our voice. And you stick your tongue out a little bit more. If you have a look, the, three, your tongue moves a little bit more forward to make the unvoiced th sound. The three children, the three, the three. So if we put this in, and they're not really connected in speech, the three, the three. So we stop and we start three, the three children, children, children. So that DR might be difficult for some speakers. Dr, dr, children, children, the three children. I hope that helps you, Jenny. Let's take a look at some of the words that were sent in. So Rashid wants to know how to pronounce porcupine. Por, por, q, pine. So it's quite short, the middle sound, porcupine, q. You can make it quite weak, q, q, porcupine, porcupine, because the stress is on the first syllable. The second syllable becomes quite weak, porcupine, which is an animal with spikes on its back. Okay, Eric wants to know how to pronounce loose and lose. These words are often confused. Loose is the opposite of tight. So if your clothes are, my clothes are quite loose. And this is pronounced with a S sound at the end, loose, loose. The second word is when you can't find something, you lose it, okay? So to lose your keys. So loose, lose. They have the same pronunciation, except in the first word, the S makes a S sound, s, loose. And in the second one, it makes a Z sound, lose. Okay, good question, Eric. Thank you very much for that. So we've got Elena, sorry, with mischievous, miss, mischievous. So the CH, mischievous, mischievous, mischievous. And that is the adjective. The noun is mischief, chief. So we want to make that long E, mischief, mischief. Okay, I hope that helps. Let's have a look here. Mohammed wants to know how to pronounce water, water, and waiter. So it's the or sound in water, water. Now, different people do pronounce water differently. Some speakers will drop the T, so they might say water, water. Americans, the T sounds a little bit more like a D, water, water. But I would say water. And waiter, so this is an A sound, water and waiter. Win, your word is swindle, swindle. So we've got to make the SW together, sw, in, swin, swindle, swindle. Okay, which means to trick someone. Luciana wants to practice these words with the A and the A sounds. Okay, so if you have a look at my mouth shape, a, a. So the tongue is making a slightly different movement at the back, but it's more about the shape of the mouth that's changing. A. Okay, so we'll practice those. We've got rang, rang, rung, rang, rung. Now, when I'm saying the ng here, with the word by itself, rang, rung, I'm pronouncing the G. But in fast speech, it's dropped. So it's just a We make this sound, the NG sound, at the back of our throat, but the G is very weak. So rang, run, rung, sorry. Ran, 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 run. Sang, sung. Sank, sunk. Began, begun. So Luciana, I recommend if you're having trouble with these words to practice very, to emphasize it. Rang, rung, okay? Practice it very strongly. Of course, when you're really speaking, you won't make such big mouth movements, but if you keep practicing it, changing your mouth shape, hopefully it will become more natural and you'll be able to pronounce the difference in your normal speech. Zaro, thank you for your message. Zaro said that they couldn't join classes for a while because they've been very busy, but don't worry, the show is always recorded and you can always check the YouTube Pronunciation Live playlist to catch up on past episodes. And Zaro, your words today are taught. So the A-U-G-H is making an or sound. And the O-U-G-H in all these words is making an or sound as well. So taught, the past tense of teach is taught. And then we've got the same th without using our voice, thought, thought. And the past tense of fight is fought. So very similar, thought and fought. To make the F sound, your top teeth just touch your lip, fought. Fought. Okay, so we've got taught, thought, fought. Amit, you sent in the phrase, you weren't a musician, and then you said want. Is it the same? I think you're asking if want and weren't have the same pronunciation. They don't have the same pronunciation. So let's practice those if they sound similar to you. You weren't a musician. You weren't a musician. So you weren't. Weren't has an sound in the middle, were, weren't. And then we need to make a n and a t at the end, weren't. You weren't a musician. It's got a z, so the s makes a z, z sound, musician, musician. You weren't a musician. So the were not becomes weren't. W-A-N-T is want. So instead of an sound in the middle, it's got an oh. Oh, can you see the shape of my mouth? Oh, want. W-a-n-t. Want. 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 Okay, so weren't, want. Weren't, want. Okay, hopefully that helps. And sorry, I can't read your name, but this was a really good question that was sent in, is how to pronounce woman and women. Now, many, many speakers make mistakes with this because they don't really look how they sound. So one, woman. So it's the O makes a sound. The same sound as in good, okay? And then M-A-N, it's a sound, okay? The schwa, the one that's very lazy to say, woman, woman, woman. Woman, one woman, but two or more women, women. It's the same sound for the O and the E, and it's an I sound, women, women, women. So one woman, many women, women. And the other word you sent in comes from French. So we pronounce it in a similar way to French speakers, and this is lingerie, lawn, lawn, lingerie, lingerie. Okay, hopefully that helps. Now, Leo, thank you for this word. This is a very interesting word for pronunciation because it's just one syllable, but there are seven consonants. And so there's a lot going on here. So let's break this down and practice. So S-T-R can be quite difficult to pronounce. So let's have a look at that. Str. Stra. So we need to make the S sound. So your tongue is just touching the top of your mouth behind your teeth. And then make a t, t, t. So your tongue is a little bit forward. And again, at the top of the teeth. St, st. So try to make that S and T sound together. St. And then if we add in the R. R, R. So your teeth are coming together to make the R sound. And your tongue is pushing against the side of your teeth, against your top teeth. So the side of your tongue should be pushing against your teeth. Stra, stra, stra. And then we've got streng, streng, eng, eng. Now the N, 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 is not happening at the front of the mouth. So to make a n sound, you touch your tongue to the top of the front of your mouth. It's happening because, again, with the NG, it's at the back. Okay, so strength, strength, strength. Now, what you might actually hear is a k sounds being added in there. Strength, strength, strength. Okay. So we'll practice that again. Strength, strength. With STR words, so I've seen in the comments, some people say, why do you say stress? It's something that many native speakers do, is they actually add in a sh sound. So when I'm talking about word stress, you might hear a slight sh sound. So people can say strength, or you might hear native speakers say strength, strength. Both are fine. I think I sometimes say strength and sometimes say strength. You can chop and change, or you can say whichever one is easiest or most comfortable for you. And spring your word is pamphlet. So this is like a small booklet, usually with some information. Pam, 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 and then ph makes a f, an f. Pamphlet, pamphlet, pamphlet. Hopefully that helps. Okay, let's take a look. We get this one so much. So in British English, it's schedule. In American English, it's with a SK, schedule. But to be honest, most British speakers will use both, or they'll chop and change as well. So either schedule or schedule, both are okay. Elena, these words come from Italian. So passata is a sauce, a tomato sauce, and mozzarella. Mozzarella is a cheese. Mozzarella, mozzarella, mozzarella. Hopefully that helps. And Pradeep, your word is exaggerate, exaggerate. So the X here is making a g, egg, followed by a z sound. Exaggerate. Exaggerate, exaggerate. Okay, and Marwa, your word is circuitous, circuitous, circuitous. And Vladislav, this word is colleague, colleague. A difficult one, because again, it doesn't look like how it's pronounced. So colleague, 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 colleague. Thanks very much. And Dari, your word is, I think, you want to say guitarist, right? So a person who plays the guitar, 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 is a guitarist. Okay. If you are just joining us, this is Pronunciation Live. If you're a little bit late to the show, don't worry. It is being recorded and it will be uploaded to YouTube and Facebook, where you can catch up, watch it from the beginning, pause it, slow it down, practice those sounds until you get them right. Let's take a look back at today's challenge. So the question today was, which of these words have three syllables? Which of these words have three syllables? By syllables, I mean the number of sounds in the word. So syllables has three syllables. Which of these words has three syllables? Loon thinks the answer is B and D. Claudia is saying B and C, and Crystal agrees with you, Claudia. Alessandra thinks B and C. Wynn thinks B and C as well, but Ju thinks B and D. Marwa thinks the answer is A. What do you think? Okay, so get in the comments box. Let me know, and we will come back and practice these words at the end of the show, and then we will have the answer. All right, let's go back to the words that were sent in. So Eunice, we've got quit and quiet. So quit, the first word here, is one syllable, and it's quit, quit, which means to stop doing something, or you could quit your job if you don't want to work there anymore. Quit, quit. The second word is two syllables. It's quai, qu, I, quai, and then ut, quiet, with a y sound in the middle. Quiet, which means shh, be quiet, quiet, quiet. So quit and quiet. Okay, thank you for sending this in, Huda Huda. It's a good question. Confused about the pronunciation of T-U in words like Tuesday, tube, and tuna. Because some dictionaries would write them tew, how I just pronounce them. So Tuesday, tube, and tuna. But Huda Huda has heard people pronouncing them with a ch sound, like a ch. Tuesday, tube, and tuna. The answer is, you are 100% right, but the answer is both are okay. Native speakers will use both. So I think the more correct pronunciation would be that Tuesday, tube, and tuna. But it's very common because it's a little bit easier for the mouth to do is a ch, Tuesday, tube, and tuna. Now, words like this where we have a t, you, tew, in American English, they often just change that to a t, ooh. So they would have Tuesday, tube, and tuna. Okay, so you could have tube and tuna. But British speakers would usually say tube and tuna or tube and tuna. So don't worry too much about it. You'll be understood. Just say whichever version is easiest for you. And another word with a tew is statue. Statue. So the same thing is happening here, Louis. We've got sta, so S-T together, st, st. Just like we practiced at the beginning of strength, st, sta, chew, chew. So it's a t, u, statue, but you can change that to a ch sound if that's easier for you. Statue, statue, statue. They sound pretty much almost exactly the same. And Ahmad, another good word here, island, island, often mispronounced because of the S. In the middle of the word there, island. We don't pronounce the S, so it's just I, land, island, island, island. And, oh, another one from Louis wanted to know how to pronounce kiss and keys, so gets confused with the sound here. So let's take a look at those. K-I-S-S has an I, I sound in the middle, I, I. And keys, the thing you use to open your door, is an E, ki, kiss, and keys. So it's a bit of a longer sound in the second word there. So I, E, I, E. So the mouth is doing a similar shape, kiss, keys, kiss, keys, kiss, keys. And it's the back of the tongue, ki, ki, keys. So in I, the back of the tongue is pushing against the top of the mouth. Kiss, kiss. Keys, the tongue is pushing against the side of the mouth. E, keys, keys. Okay, so practice that a little bit, Louis, and I hope that gets a bit easier for you. All right, let's take a look back at the comments. I can't read your name, but I'm sorry, but this word is yacht, yacht. So a type of boat is yacht. It's a rhyming word with not. Or hot, okay? So it's just a y, o, t sound. Doesn't look like how it sounds, does it? Yacht, yacht. Yuchi, your word is scenario. S, so it's just an S sound at the beginning. S, s, scenario. S, scenario. Scenario, which means a scene or a situation. Mari, your words are squirrel, squi, squi. So if we've got a S and a qu sounds, and then I, squi, squirrel, roll, squirrel, squirrel, which is a type of animal you might see in the park, and quarrel, quarrel, which means to fight with words, quarrel, to argue, qua, quarrel, squirrel, quarrel. So we've got an I in squirrel and an a in qua, quarrel, qua. So we're making this a shape with our mouth, quarrel. Okay, let's see what else we've got here. Win, your word is zeal, zeal, zeal. So z, eel, eel, eel. Can you see how the mouth open, widens and then falls back? Eel, eel, zeal. And Kozu, your word is scalp. So the skin, this part of your head, the skin on under your hair is your scalp. Sc-alp, scalp, scalp. And Trong, your word is stomachache. Okay, let's have a look. So we've got stomach, 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 ache, ache. So ache with a k at the end, stomach ache. But when we say this all together, stomach, cake. So the k at the end of stomach joins the beginning of a, stomach cake, stomach cakes. It's almost like cake that you eat, stomach cake, stomach cake, stomach cake. So effect, effect, and effect. Okay, so affect, sorry, affect and effect. A, eh. So the A is a, affect. This has affected me. And the second one is the effect. Effect, effect. And Manzo, your word is menace, menace. So someone that causes you trouble or harm is a menace, menace. And Mario, your words are this, is this, and these. Okay, so T-H-I-S is an I. So it's the same as Louis with kiss and keys, the same difference, this and these. Okay, so you can see that the mouth is widening, E. So this, these, the same thing happening with the tongue there. Okay, let's take a look at your word, Shala. Pleasure, ple, eh, ple, pleasure, zh, pleasure, and please. Okay, E. So again, keys, these, please are all making the same sound there. Keys, please, these. Okay, so we've got this ease with a z sound at the end there. Okay, let's take a look at this question. Cynthia, geography and getting. Is it true that the difference in pronunciation of the G depends on the letter following it? Yes, so there are general rules with the letter G, but they don't, with, as always with English, doesn't always follow the rules. So here we've got geography, which is a j sound, geography. Geography, geography. Usually, if G is followed by I, geography, giant, it's a j sound. And getting, okay, we've got getting, get. Very often, when it's followed by an E, we have a g, g sound to G there. Okay, Mario, I won't do woman and women. You'll have to watch the show again because we did these already. But we've also got and end. A, and, A-N-D, and, E-N-D, end, end, and ends. If you have a look at the shape of the mouth. Let's take a look here. And Eric, your words are bean. And bean, they have the same pronunciation, bean and bean. With men, it's man, one man, two men, man, men, which is different from woman and women, women, because it becomes woman is mun and min. Different if it's for the male, it's man, men. Okay, hopefully that helps. Mohammed, your word is qualifications. 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 And Hesham, we get this word a lot as well. In British English, weirdly, it is pronounced lieutenant. Lieutenant. In American English, it's usually pronounced lieutenant. Lieutenant, which looks, which sounds a lot more like it looks. Diana, your word is laugh. L, a, f, laugh, laugh. So the GH makes a f sound at the end. Laugh, laugh. And Hafiz, this word comes from French, and so it's pronounced quite differently by different people. In English, I would say croissant. I try to copy the French pronunciation. So many people will say croissant, but I've also heard people say croissant, croissant. It's up to you, croissant or croissant. But many people have their own pronunciation. So I think whatever you feel comfortable with is actually fine. Okay, let's have a look. Man is longer than men. Yes, when pronouncing man, men, man, men. So we are hanging on to this sound a little bit longer, you're right. And Roger, your word is coincidence. Coincidence, coincidence, coincidence. And these words are infrastructure, infrastructure. So again, we've got this STR, infrastructure, infrastructure, infrastructure. We spent a little bit of time with STR earlier on in the show. So if you've just joined us and you want to practice that, please do watch the show again. Infrastructure. We've also got beer, beer. So a drink, beer. Bird, this is an sound, bird, bird. Beard, so if you have hair growing on this part of your face, it is a beard, beard. So beer and beard have the same pronunciation, but beard has a d added on at the end. And please, did you want me to put, I think you were just being polite. Those were the words, please. All right, and Kit Kat, your word is karaoke. Karaoke. So this word comes from Japanese, I believe. Karaoke. In English, we pronounce it karaoke. Karaoke. And let's take a look here. We've got, your words are owl, owl, and own. So if you borrow money from someone and you need to pay them back, you owe the money, has the same pronunciation as own. To own means to have something. It belongs to you. Own, but then we add a n at the end. Okay, so own, but the animal is owl. Okay, so it's got a different vowel sound. Owl, owl, owl. It almost becomes two syllables. Owl, owl, owl. Same as vowel or towel. All right, let's go back to today's challenge. And my question today was, which of these words have three syllables? So what do you think? Get in the comments box and let me know. And in just a moment, I will read the words and then you can see if you still agree with your answer. So Matto thinks the answer is B. Claudia thinks B and C. Muniba thinks C and D. I've lost that one. Lady Lena thinks A and C. Febby thinks B. Bon thinks B. Diego thinks B and D. Alessandra thinks A, B and C. What do you think? Okay, I'm going to read the words to you and then see if you still agree with your answer. So A is valuable, valuable, valuable. B is awareness, awareness, awareness. C is obviously, obviously. And D, it's a French word, but we do use it in English, is monsieur, monsieur, monsieur. So the correct answer was dun, 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 A and B. So valuable. Many of you got B, not many people got A. So we wouldn't say valuable, 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 as three syllables. Awareness, awareness, awareness. Obviously has four and monsieur has two syllables. So A and B were the correct answer. Did anybody get that right? I can't find anybody here. Elena thought A, B, and C. Martha thought A and C. Evgeny had B and C. Did nobody get the right answer? There must be somebody. Oh, someone said they got it. Yuji wanted to answer A. Congratulations. Well done. And Ju said A and B. So fantastic and well done to you. Thank you very much for joining today's show. If I didn't get a chance to get to your word, I'm very sorry. Please do join us next Tuesday at 1:30 UK time for Pronunciation Live. We are always here Tuesday and Thursday at 1:30. Don't forget, tomorrow is the Fun Friday quiz, also at 1:30 UK time. If you have enjoyed the show, please hit that like button. If you love the show, you can hit that heart button. And please do share this with anybody that you think might want to benefit from some pronunciation practice. So that's everything from me. Thank you so much for joining. Well done on all your hard work with your pronunciation. And I look forward to seeing you next time. Bye-bye.